The last prophet in the world, last prophet in the world, last prophet in the world to show how to be closer to Allah. He is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
After the return from the seventh sky and Sidratul Muntaha, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed the people about the journey of Isra and the Miraj. Hearing that, every single non-Muslims were extremely surprised. Even when the Muslims heard about it, they also could not believe in the story of the miracle journey. People started thinking that the journey was a made-up story. And because of that, some of the Muslims lost their faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, most of the Muslims did have a strong faith in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Among them was Abu Bakr, peace be upon him, who was a very special person in Islam. When the bad people went to Abu Bakr, peace be upon him, and told him about the miracle journey, he immediately believed the story because he knew that the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is never wrong. From that day, Abu Bakr was given a name, Siddiq, which means the one who believes. Hearing about the Isra and the Miraj, it was an extremely big news in Mecca because the people had never heard any lie from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, when they heard about this news, they thought that it would be their best chance to prove Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a false prophet. There were some people who previously visited Masjid al-Aqsa, so they wanted to test Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked for every single detail and description about the Al-Aqsa Mosque. However, since Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wasn't lying and he was actually there, he wasn't wrong. So, no one could find any mistakes in what he was saying. Many didn't believe him, but little did they know that they were wrong, especially after the second proof that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going to give. Do you remember after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came back from the miracle journey, how he saw a group of travelers who were headed for Mecca?
Yes, that was one of the last things he saw that night, right?
You're right! So, the Prophet also told the people about the group of travelers who were coming towards Mecca. He told them about the very detailed information about the travelers, including how many camels they had, their condition, and the time that they would arrive at Mecca. That caravan, which was a group of travelers coming to Mecca, came exactly when the Prophet said that they would. Everyone saw that his description was accurate, and seeing that, many people believed in the Prophet. However, the bad people still did not become Muslims. The next couple of days, Jibrail, peace be upon him, visited Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam during each prayer time to teach how and when to do the daily prayers. And that's how people slowly started doing the daily five times prayer. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam started to focus on how to spread Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's message to the people outside of Mecca. Before the Hajj time, every year there were three huge fairs that were held around Mecca. That was a very good opportunity to find a large audience so that he could invite the people to Islam. Unfortunately, the tribes from the other towns did not accept Islam. They weren't rude to the Prophet. Instead, they were very polite and gentle. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his followers used to go to the new people during the night time to avoid the bad people who used to disturb the Muslims. During the 10th year of the prophethood, very good things started to happen. 6 great people from Medina came for Hajj. In their town, their neighbor was Jews, and from those Jews, they heard that a new prophet would come to save the world. The Jewish people were waiting for the great prophet for a long time. So, one night, those 6 people were sitting near Mina, which was just outside of Kaaba. Soon, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came and talked to them about Islam. When Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told them some of the verses from the Quran, those 6 smart people immediately recognized the Prophet and accepted Islam. They were very happy that they accepted the Prophet before the Jews, who were waiting for a long, long time for a Prophet. At that time, the tribes from Medina used to fight with each other. They did not have a friendly relationship with each other's tribes. So, after converting to Islam, they promised to spread Islam to their own people and bring peace to their society. They also said that if Islam united the tribes together, the people of Medina would respect and love Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they spread the news of Islam all over Medina. And because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened a new door for them.
MashaAllah, that's very good news. What did they do after that?
The next year, those 6 smart Muslims from Medina brought 7 new people to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam who accepted Islam. They promised in the name of Allah to be a good Muslim and follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's laws and orders. In history, this was the first formal oath in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To guide those new Muslims and spread Islam in Medina, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam decided to send Muswab, peace be upon him, to Medina. Muswab, peace be upon him, was a very young Muslim who accepted Islam during the 4th year of prophethood. He was the first ambassador of Islam. In Medina, the ambassador stayed with Asad, peace be upon him. Both of them started to teach the non-Muslims about Islam. They were very smart, gentle, and brave. One day, Muswab and Asad, peace be upon them, was taking a rest in a garden. One of the leaders named Saad, peace be upon him, did not like that they were teaching about Islam. So, he sent his cousin to kick them out from Medina. After the cousin got his weapon, he came to those Muslims, Muswab and Asad, peace be upon them, and threatened those 2 Muslims to leave Medina. And if they would not leave, he would kill both of them. Muswab, peace be upon him, was very calm and requested the angry man to sit and listen to him for a little bit. When the angry man started to listen to Muswab, peace be upon him, his mind changed and he became a Muslim. Then he advised the Muslims that if they could change his cousin's mind, which was one of the leaders of Medina, all of the people in his tribe would become Muslims. Then, the new Muslim made a plan and went to his cousin, who was the leader. Hearing about the Muslims from his own cousin, The leader, Sa'd, became very angry and came to the Muslims with his weapon. At that time, Muswab, peace be upon him, was very calm and requested the angry leader to sit and listen to him for a little bit. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings, the leader's mind was changed and he also became a Muslim. Then he went to his people and told them that if they don't accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as their God and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as their prophet, he would not talk to them anymore.
So, did a lot of people in his tribe become Muslims?
Yes! With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's great blessings, by that evening, almost all of the men and women from that tribe became Muslims. There was only one person from that tribe that didn't become a Muslim right away. However, he did become a Muslim before the Battle of Uhud. Within 1 year, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help, Muswab, peace be upon him's success of spreading Islam was extremely good. Many people from each tribe became Muslims. And as time went by, Medina became a blessing land and it was filled with many new Muslims.
These series are going to have several episodes and it is all thanks to you for supporting us. You can donate today to help us make more Islamic content by giving us a one-time donation or becoming a monthly member for the whole thing.
The Prophet Stories.